Thank you very much. So this is a zine I wrote called My Little Remstad, which is about a Norwegian oil supply vessel. But I won't give away any more spoilers before I start. So it goes something like this. This scene is a love story, and it's a love story like most other love stories, apart from one subtle difference that the cover, title, and everything else about what I have in my hand here strongly hints at. It's about the love for a little Norwegian oil supply vessel called Remstad. Let me take you back to October 2015. Bored at work, but feeling generally quite stressed about everything, I decided to browse the website Norwegian Webcams. To clarify, this website includes links to loads of different webcams around Norway, pointed at busy city centre squares, remote snowy islands and quiet country lanes. I was looking for something that I could alt and tab to between grappling with a very boring spreadsheet. I was looking for something to take my mind off things. Then I stumbled across a webcam with the title Webkamera med utsikt fra taket på Fosnavåg Rederi Park ut över Bresundet med Rundebranden i bakgrunden över Myre. I think I nailed the pronunciation there. The webcam was pointing across the sea from the harbour at a town called Fosnavåg over to the island of Remøya. And it's a beautiful view, don't get me wrong. But what caught my eye was something a little bit closer to the foreground. It was Remstad, a small red ship moored in the harbour. Should have got a lectern. Now, to give you a bit of background information, I'm originally from Grimsby, which is famous for being a big fishing town. It's not so much anymore, but the port is still quite busy. Everyone knows someone who's worked at sea, and my dad spent most of his life either at sea in a merchant navy, or on trawlers, or working on the docks. This maritime heritage, I can't do air quotes with that hand, I have to do this hand. This maritime heritage is probably the only thing I ever really liked about my dad, because it means I can now say things like, the sea's kind of in my blood, you know, and get away with it. I like the idea of being at sea in the middle of nowhere, bobbing around on a little ship, and then getting bored of being in the middle of nowhere and being so excited at the sight of land and going home and having something nice for my tea. I imagined myself stood on the deck of Remstad and seeing Fosnavåg in the distance, knowing that I was nearly there. Or something like that anyway. Of course, being on a ship out at sea probably isn't that lovely. It's probably pretty miserable, IRL. But back to the webcam. Remstad was completely still. There was no sign of a crew and no sign of any port workers doing anything either. It's an oil supply vessel, and it appeared to be empty, so I assumed that whatever it had unloaded, whatever it had been loaded with had been unloaded already. Every time the webcam refreshed, I looked very hard for the slightest change, but aside from the odd bird flying past, I didn't spot much. Something about this little boat drew me to it, though. I felt like we had a connection for some reason, like I could relate to it. I was sat at work wishing I could go home, and Remstad was sat in admittedly more picturesque surroundings, probably wanting to go home too, whatever that means for a boat. We were both waiting for something. Me for the end of core hours so I could clock off and get my train. Remstad for, I don't know, the tide or its crew to come back or something, whatever boats hang around for. It was 4 p.m. Norwegian time and it was already starting to go dark. The webcam, updating every 60 seconds, showed the little ship's lights flicker on until you couldn't see the beautiful view anymore. You could just see Remstad illuminated in the pitch darkness. I started thinking about Remstad, or Lil Remstad as I started calling it, and wondered where it had come from and where it had been and where it was going. I'd been watching the motionless boat for a while now, and then I suddenly thought to myself, one day this little red ship will leave Fosnavåg and maybe I'll never see it again. I started thinking about Remstad and all the journeys it had been on previously. I wanted to find out all about it, like if I'd met Lil Remstad at a party and I was making small talk, I might have asked it, what do you do? Now this is obviously a stupid thing to ask anybody at a party, let alone an oil supply vessel, but I'm bad at small talk so I might well have done this. If I'd asked Lil Remstad what it did, what would it say? Now, I did some background reading on the internet, and it turns out you can find out lots of information about ships if you're really interested. And I was able to find out quite a lot of information about Remstad. online. So I put together a little fact file, which I detailed in my zine here. But I'll give you a few basic facts so you know what we're talking about here. Remstad is a PSV UT-746 oil supply vessel. It was built at Bratvåg Skipsverft in 1996, so it's 20 years old this year. And it's about 87.7 metres long and about 18 metres wide, if you imagine how big that is. And it has a gross tonnage of 3,603 BRT. Absolutely no idea what that means, but it sounds quite heavy. Day two came, and I started seeing people in high-vis clothing wandering about on deck. I took a deep breath and said, "They'll be leaving soon," to myself in the office. Thankfully, nobody else was in the room at the time. And I thought about the little ship and how maybe these last couple of hours would be our last together. Then a friend alerted me to the fact that you can track ships on the internet. Of course you can. Of course you can track ships on the internet. So I managed to find Mil Remstad in the database, and there it was, clearly moored in Fosnavåg, so it was definitely working. Theoretically, I could keep track of this boat forever, and then maybe it'd stop at other harbours with webcams too, and I could follow Mil Remstad on all of its adventures. I found out that it had most recently come from a place called Maloy. Now, I don't know about you, but I'm not great with Norwegian geography, so I looked it up, and it's bloody miles away. You can't really tell from that map, but there's a line from one place to the other, and there's lots of other stuff in between. It's quite a long way. So been a busy ship. From the pictures I'd seen on the internet, it seemed like Lil Remstad spent most of its time taking supplies to oil rigs. I can imagine that the sight of Lil Remstad on the horizon was a pretty nice thing for people stuck on oil rigs for weeks at a time. I reckon it was mainly loaded with equipment and useful stuff. I'd also like to think that somewhere on Lil Remstad there's an area for taking the workers' dead nice food from the mainland, like a floating bulk cargo delivery. The crew of Lil Remstad stood on deck waving happily as they approach, trying to communicate the message, "We have had to substitute your economy sausages for premium ones," by Morse code. In the zine, I made a nifty diagram of what the boat would look like if you sliced it up. I'll describe it to you. The top deck is kind of largely empty because that's where stuff gets stored. The second deck has just got loads of circles on, which probably means something but completely meaningless to me. And the bottom deck is called the tank top, which to my mind is an item of knitted clothing but also has more circles on it. Who knows? As I started to drift towards the end of the week, carried only by the current and a strong desire not to be at work for 2 days, I kept refreshing the tab that the webcam feed was open on. I was willing Lil Remstad to head off. Perhaps that would give me closure. Every single time I checked back, I swore it moved a little bit. But then 5, 10, 15 minutes later, it was still securely moored in Fosnavåg. My obsession was getting to be a bit much, to be honest. At one point, I found myself searching through a Norwegian ship spotters forum. I found some nice photos there. And watching a YouTube video of our Lil Remstad in action, which I would definitely recommend watching. If you go on YouTube and type in Remstad, there's a beautiful kind of like a video of Remstad docked somewhere, which is filmed on a drone. So the drone just goes round and round the ship while there's some kind of pumping trance music in the background. It's fantastic. Go for it. If I had my way, we could have just played that, and I wouldn't have to bother with all this today. But then I stumbled across some sensational but actually quite horrifying news. A report on a local news Facebook page about Remstad. I managed to translate the page from Norwegian into English using Google Translate, and I discovered that our little tug pal wasn't feeling very well. And this is what it said. It said, "Last Friday came news, PSV vessel Remstad laid up in Fosnavåg. In afternoon boat came in place by Sunnmørsfisk Key. Remuli Shipping aims to get the boat working again." As I write this, in November 2015, Lil Remstad is still in Fosnavåg. Every day I check to see whether it's made a recovery and whether it's still there. I check the webcam every couple of hours just to make sure it's not gone. I hope I get to see it leave Fosnavåg, but if I don't, I've at least had a little bit longer with it. That's the end of the zine. While you may be hoping that that's the end of the story, it most certainly is not. There's more. I just saw the paper out. Get there eventually. So So that was November 2015, but the story has moved on since then. It's got more exciting, if you can imagine. So between November and December, I regularly checked the webcam to see what Remstat was up to, and the answer was not a lot. It was still moored at Fosnavåg, completely still, nothing happening, no one about. Then on December the 22nd, as I was gearing up for Christmas, and presumably everybody on board was as well, the webcam stopped working. It stopped updating, and it kind of felt like a member of the family had died. So I sent an email to the company who ran the webcam, saying, "Do you know your webcam's not working? I really need to watch this boat." They sent a very polite reply saying, "Oh, there's a systems problem, but we'll get on that eventually. Why are you watching this webcam?" To which I didn't really have an answer, so I just said it was quite relaxing looking at it. And then they stopped replying at that point, because I think they thought it was weird. So I still had my link to Remstein, but I could look at the ship tracker, so I could see like a little diagram on a map, just to make sure it hadn't gone anywhere or sank or anything. And it was still there. So I still checked that every day as we moved into January, February, March. And then something happened. I found a different ship and a different webcam. There's a passenger ferry that goes up and down the Norwegian coast called Finnmarken, which actually has a webcam on board, so you can look at wherever it's going rather than just looking out at a stationary ship in a port. And that was really exciting to me. So I kept track of that ship, and I kind of dropped the ball with Remstat a little bit, because the next time I looked, it moved. I googled Remstat and actually found a news story in a Norwegian newspaper that has the headline, "It is with sadness that we sell the old lady," about Remstat. And it turns out that after 2 decades under contract with a company that had operated Remstat, they'd actually sold her or him or it to an Indian company and changed its name to something called Tag 20. Which, Tag 20, you can't fall in love with a boat called Tag 20. Jesus. Anyway, the press release said, "Yes, now is the old lady our sold." This is Google Translate, by the way. This is not my attempt at translating Norwegian. "There is Indian company who is buying, and they took over boat last Saturday. It is with sadness, boss of Remoy Shipping, emit 20 years old supply ship. But in these times, it is also good to get it done," he said. "It has been difficult to find a buyer for Remstat in an offshore market where it is not exactly a shortage of available tonnage. It was not easy, but we do not need so many buyers as long as we find the right one. They did, therefore, in India." And that's the end of Remstat. So Remstat is now called Tag 20, and if you look on the ship tracking website, you can still find Remstat, but it says, "Actually, did you mean Tag 20? And the ship at the moment is currently just passing through the Suez Canal. It's going towards India, where it's going to be repurposed for its new owner. And at the time when I found out about this, I felt like I felt real grief about losing the ship. But now I feel like it's a new opportunity to follow a different character. It'd be the same person, the same boat, but in different circumstances. And maybe I'll be able to see new webcams and new harbours around India and the subcontinent that will be just as good. So that's kind of the end of the Remstat story. But I'd encourage you to check any ship tracking websites for Remstat, or Tag 20 as it's now called, so you can keep up to date with what's going on there. That's it. Bye.